how are you? I'm Mr. Moso. Today we want to talk about the political organization of the Ndebele state, what was done in the Ndebele state politically. So we are going to look on four important aspects that were done in the Ndebele state. We are going to talk about the role that was done by the king, Inkosi Yami. We are also going to talk about the role that was done by the army, Amajaha Amabutho. Then we also talk about the role that was done by the people who assisted the Inkosi, the people who assisted the king. Then we eventually talk about the military organization of the Ndebele state. Let's start with the role that was played by Inkosi Yami. What did the Inkosi, what did the king do in the Ndebele state? He was responsible for allocating land, the Inkosi. He was responsible for also leading the army during the time of war. They were going to attack a neighboring tribe. They were going to attack a neighboring state. The Inkosi, he was supposed to lead the people as they went to attack the neighboring state or a tribe. The Inkosi, he was also responsible for controlling all the trading activities that took place in the state. Then we also see that the Inkosi, he was assisted to rule by who? By Induna Enkulu, provisional leader. He was also assisted to rule by Induna. Who were the Indunas? We are talking about the chiefs. They played also an important part in the political organization of the Ndebele state. Then we also see that the king, Inkosi Yami, he was also assisted to rule by the Mpakati. Who were the Mpakati? The Mpakati, these were the relatives of the king. They gave the king advice. You know, Inkosi Yami, do this and that. Inkosi Yami, let's do that and this. They were given advice. He was given advice by the Mpakati. Then he was also assisted to rule by Izikulu, Kulu, Ukuluwami. Ukuluwami, those elderly members in the society, those people who had wisdom in the society, they gave the Inkosi advice on what was supposed to take place in the state. Then let's now talk about the role of the army. The army, it played an important part in the political organization of the Ndebele state. Here, attacking the enemy. Here, we are going to die today. Here, I can kill and attack you today. The army was so significant. It went to war barefooted for great speed. And we see that they were not allowed to marry until the age of 40. The army, we also see that they used the cow horn formation there to encircle the enemy and attack. Enemy encircled and attack. Enemy encircled, then attack. So we see that the cow horn formation, it was significant. Then the army also, it was organized into age regiments. These regiments, they had specific names, and they were not names. So these regiments, they were also significant in the political organization of the Ndebele state. Young boys, young girls, they were also used as carrier packages and spies. So we see that the military organization of the Ndebele state, it was so significant. And so that is what we have on the political military organization of the Ndebele state. Here, the Ndebele state with Mr. Moso. Thank you.